project going?
Well, as you can see, Greg, we've gotten all the new brick up here since you were here last. All new windows, new roof. Put all new sewer system in, drain tile around the home, yeah, so we don't have
really
any flooding issues.
The next process is the insulation, which is a blown-in composite of recycled paper material.
And good R value?
Very good R value, high density, put it in. Real nice. Also, in the bathroom areas, in the floor, for soundproofing, and it also helps with the insulation of the pipes, so we don't have any freezing issues. So, L-shaped kitchen, right across here with an island. Set up island with some stools on the opposite side. Kind of opens up into the family
back
room
the
then,
family,
so
you can see it's nice,
pretty messy,
messy,
but to give it some kind of idea, there's going to be a fireplace, nice wooden mantle. Not a formal fireplace, but more.
The cabinet's going to be a
family room.
You know?
This is what the homeowner has chosen. Two different colors, but which is kind of popular right now. They're going with a kind of a darker island. And lighter for the main part of the kitchen.
What we've done is we've cornered the stove, gives it a little more uniqueness. Double oven, and you're standing right where the refrigerator is going
to go. The walk-in closet, and it's going to fit two single beds.
We've got two furnaces in the home.
So it's zoned?
It's going to be zoned for upstairs.
So high efficiency?
It's an 80% efficient furnace. This is going to be the kids' bathroom, whirlpool, steamer area, shower combination, you know. This is really nice. It's going to be a steamer combination, like I said, shower combination. We pour the floor, we create our own area basically. We put cement before the rubber, then we mesh in the cement, then we put the rubber, then we put more cement, and then we complete it by putting the tile on it. This is wallboard we use. Because it's going to be a steam area, we don't want any drywall in here at all. All solid, what they call concrete board, Durarock. Good application, but tiles, no issues with the moisture.
Vanity.
And
this
is going to be a toilet.
Coming off
vanity.
The wall,
so double sink vanity. And then we're hoping we can fit the large towel closet here. What the goal is.
You know. Flooring, just regular tongue and groove.
Oak flooring, you know, be installed right over this subfloor area after it's cleaned up. It'll have one coat of stain because they want to darken it, and then we'll put three coats of polyurethane on it.
The aspect
of the, if you're entertaining and you were able to have a lot of people that you wanted to send the kids down, I wanted to become part of the living space, so we kept all the basement area accessible to the living space. We didn't put any doors, so you basically come down the stairs. This is going to end up
at the fireplace in the corner here.
And this will be either tile or carpeted. And it will create a... Anyway, you can
so here's the old back wall of the house.
The old back wall, which we, you know, we cut out the old foundation. Obviously, we have a lot of old wires here hanging down. It was part of the old home. We have brand new 200-amp servers which is plenty of breakers.
We're going to build them some built-in closets here for the kids where they can hang their coats. With some closets above, and like I said, this is obviously a tiled area. If you want to tell the kids, go ahead down the basement down here. And what I like to do is separate it from the living space, so we create this storage area. You'll have a door, storage area for the lady to store her brooms and vacuums, and then we'll have another door into the bathroom. And that then in turn separates it from the living space. You're not walking from the bathroom straight into the family room.
Right.
And then we insulate the walls for sound wherever it meets with the living space.
All new windows. I got the old windows, put in new windows. All new sewer system. There's all new electric, new everything.
It's just part of the building
infrastructure in the house.
They want to know. They come and see and they sign off on all this stuff. See
roof
if you've done
siding
it.
Is roof is on. The siding is going to be coming. It's ordered. It's going to be what they call a hardy plank. It's a cement composite. Real durable. Real weather resistant and aesthetically a little more pleasing to the eye than vinyl. New porch area with pillars. This is going to have a concrete slab above it.
So who designed the front of the house?
The homeowner
basically,
and the draftsman that we used.